everybody, Shoshana here. And I just arrived for the Compass Retreat in one of the coolest spots I've ever been to. Welcome to Atlanta.
Yo, welcome to Atlanta where the players play. And we ride on them things like every day. Big beats hit streets, see gangsters roaming. And parties don't stop till 8 in the morning.
So we are headed to the Four Seasons in Atlanta where I'm going to be registering for the start of the Compass Retreat to get my little name badge and connect with all our Compass peeps.
3 hours later.
So we checked in. I got my priority access badge. Unfortunately, Kurt, he's not getting into any parties. Come behind the scenes with me as I figure out, you know, how to video myself. I'm not a pro in that. Real estate, that's my game. Woo! I'm gonna get hit by a car. Not good.
Is that bitch o'clock? Yeah, it's thick 30. I've been through a lot, but I'm still flirty.
We are at Piedmont Park in Atlanta, and this is event number one for the Compass Retreat. I am super excited to see all of my friends that I haven't seen in a really long time from all over the U.S. And what a beautiful night here in Atlanta, Georgia.
I'm way too fine to be distressed, yeah.
I'm in Monmouth and Ocean County in Central New Jersey. It actually exists, Central New Jersey. Oh. I have that on my badge here. So I help a lot of first-time home buyers. I honestly help anyone at any price point.
Okay.
And yeah, that's
awesome.
10 minutes from Asbury Park. So
okay.
I have a lot of shore towns around me.
Perfect.
And a lot of different downtown areas in New Jersey too.
If you need anyone in New Jersey, Emily is the person to call.
Reach out to me, baby.
Yeah. Mark Pina is responsible for me being here this evening. He is like the king of Compass. I mean, Robert Revkin, we all know that.
I think the king of Compass is over there somewhere.
Okay, but
I just do what I can. Show enough.
We got lots of shows here tonight. I met Steve. We were at the line.
That's right.
And he and his team, they were on the dance floor. But they were doing double dutch. Like,
just like that?
It was like that?
It was just jumping in.
And we were like,
with nothing there.
Yeah.
We wanted to get the party started.
Steve's like one of the coolest people I know at Compass.
Thank you.
He's a DJ. He's like a freaking rock star. And this is his lovely woman, Jackie.
Yes. Also Compass agent.
Also so Compass agent.
Compass fam is here.
Did you look any better?
Oh, I mean, right?
Annoying.
Look at them.
Thank you.
I absolutely love her. She's freaking super cool. She teaches bar and spin, and she rides motorcycles, and like, look at her, like, hot as hell.
I think I called you my sister from another mister last night.
Yes.
So I'm with Beverly Hills. I'm with a group called Voyage with Ari Afshar. We service Beverly Hills area, and LA is so broad, it's really hard just to pinpoint one area. We'll go, you know, we'll spread it to Santa Monica, all the way to downtown LA, to the Valley. So we cover a pretty wide range of...
They sell some sick homes. Like, who are we kidding? You know, if this show takes off, I may be buying one of them.
That's right, that's right.
I like you, but you're crazy.
He is like the man at Compass DMV, and I'm so excited to be here. And you're like the host of this party, so.
Thank you for being here.
Yeah.
It's an awesome night. We got tons of great people here. Great venue at Hotel Clermont in Atlanta. And I'm happy to be here.
So tell me about the sneaker thing. Why? What was the whole
sneaker? So one of our co-hosts started Kicks of Compass. His name is Luke. He's over there from Boston.
Cool.
And so he loves kicks. You got some nice kicks on yourself.
I got my Jordans on. Look at that.
Got the dunks on. And so he has a great Instagram page called Kicks of Compass. He highlights agents and their shoes. And so hope you should get highlighted.
I love it.
Some great kicks.
I know. I need to like post them on Instagram.
We interrupt this program to bring you a special report.
The best thing was meeting my idol, Mel Robbins. She was the keynote speaker. We had an opportunity to have breakfast together. You know, she's my new best friend. She was the keynote speaker. Did I say that already? I might have said that already, but that's how great she was.
So I am here with the Andrew Jevin, also known as the Snapping Realtor, and he is holding a special social media event with his badass colleague, Taya DiCarlo.
The beginning of COVID, I got a bunch of agents together to work on their social media together, and I wanted an event where we got together to not just talk about like our business, but to actually get social and get to know each other. And I didn't expect that it was gonna be this big. Everybody in this room cares about social media, and that it's been the most important part of my business. 65% of my business has come from agent to agent referral, and that all comes from Instagram. She's the best.
You know, I try. I'm trying to like live up to this guy. Thank you so much for hosting this great event.
Thank you for coming. Okay. You know what?
So we are here at the Rowdy Tiger in Atlanta. It's a happy hour on behalf of the 6 p.m.ers. We had a breakfast this morning for the 6 a.m.ers, but there's another group in the evening for folks who can't get up super early. This is my friend, Julian Aguirre. He has created the 6 p.m.ers group, and I thought it would be super awesome for him to explain a little bit about how it came to be.
No, I mean, honestly, it's just been like having fun, getting to know people. We started up a happy hour, like, when the pandemic started, and it was like 8 of us, maybe 10. I said, well, if we just keep doing it, people will remember it, then they'll come.
Yeah.
And so we kept doing it, and then we went to like twice a month, and it just kind of evolved. Most of us don't get up at 6 a.m.
Right, yeah.
You know, which is fine. I appreciate what they're doing, it's amazing. So a lot of us are like the type that just, we like to go to happy hour, we're up later, I go to bed at midnight every night. You know, a lot of us are that kind of person. 31 straight months we've been doing this. I can't believe it's been that long, but
right.
I mean, you've come sometimes. Some people over here have came. It's never the same group.
Yeah.
And I tell people, come for a little while or stay the whole time. It's totally up to you.
Yeah. And what I love so much about him is he's like a super connector. Like, he definitely connects people, and we love to have fun. And, you know, I'm so impressed by you and
all
the
fun
stuff that you put together. So I really appreciate this event, and thanks for hanging. Yeah.
Appreciate
he's awesome. Thank
awesome.
You. Thank you, honey. I have to say, I had the most unbelievable time. First of all, that was the first time I had been in Atlanta, and it was a really fun city. I got to hang with some of my best friends at Compass across the US. Plus, I met a whole bunch of new people that are my new besties. And of course, there was an amazing party. This party was held at Pullman Yards, where they actually filmed The Hunger Games.
This is where they filmed The Hunger Games. Did you know that?
What did they do?
They filmed The Hunger Games here.
No, seriously?
Yeah.
Here?
Yeah. Absolutely love being a part of such a great community at Compass. It was the 10-year decennial celebration. I've been with Compass now for 5 of those 10 years, and it's just amazing to me how the company has grown. Thank you so much for checking out the show. See you next year in San Diego, baby. Like and subscribe. Right? We can't forget that.